In this video, I'm going to show you how to make this movie. This movie is using a single layer and has a second movie playing in the background. The background movie and the source movie are inside your Studio Artist folder in a folder called A Few Source Images and Movies. So you can use those to recreate this tutorial if you want to. I have the original source movie loaded here, but I'm going to need a white background so it will be transparent against the background movie. So first I need to clean this source movie up. To do that, I am going to record a paint action sequence and drag this first frame into the canvas. This will be the first recorded step. Now I'll clean this video up by going to selection mode to mask out the background. I'm going to choose canvas and then global color. There's an option here to have a feathered, soft or hard edge. I'm going to choose the hard edge option. Also, I need to make sure masking is checked. Now I will mouse down in the canvas and mask out the light purple background. And now you'll see this masking step has been added to the paint action sequence. Now I will choose the erase pull down menu and choose white. There are also these black lines on the side of the video and I want to white those out as well. So now I will choose the rectangle mask and select this first dark bar. Then I'll hold down shift to get this little bit I missed. Then while I'm still holding down shift, I will mask out the other bar. And then again, I will erase the selection to white. The next step that I need to do to make this work properly is to toggle to the paint action sequence mode. Here are the paint action sequence presets you're familiar with, and here's the toggle button to the editor. So I need to toggle over to the editor to turn on the mask playback. This is also true if you're using layers to make a movie. Now I'm ready to output my masked movie by choosing action, process with a paint action sequence, and then choose source to movie and then name the output movie. And now it's processing. Now we have a cleaned up source video to work with. And again, this cleaned up video is in your Studio Artist folder in the Few Source Images and Videos folder. Now I'm going to load this cleaned up video to the source area by dragging and dropping it. Next I'm going to go to the paint action sequence presets and choose the movies collection. And the cartoon flat category and choose this preset called cartoon cutout with shadow and circles. Then I'm going to click play in the paint action sequence to make sure this is the one I wanted. So right now you can see it doesn't have the countdown background video. That's the step I'm going to add next. To bring in the background video, I need to add a context step, which is very simple. Just choose action, paint action sequence timeline, then record context multiple keys and finally content and then choose the background movie that you want. I'm going to choose the countdown movie, which is also in your Studio Artist folder with the movie of the dancer. When this window appears, just click cancel. So now you'll see that a step called content context has been added to the paint action sequence. This step needs to be the first step because it's going to be the background. So I need to drag it to the top of the paint action sequence. Then I am going to mute this purple background step since I am replacing the purple background with the countdown movie. So now I'll click play just to see how it looks. That looks right. So now I'm ready to output the final movie by choosing action, process with a paint action sequence, then source to movie. And then I'll name the output movie. Now it is rendering out each frame of both movies. And here's the final movie. The next tutorial for this project is going to show you how to edit this paint action sequence to apply it to another video.